Hi everyone, my name is Vanessa Lagos and today I'm going to talk about the processing and obtaining of palm oil and byproducts for animal nutrition. This is the outline of this presentation. I will start with a background about palm oil production, then I will talk about the processing of palm oil extraction. I will move then into the byproducts of the whole process. Then I will talk about the swine nutrition interest byproducts, and at the end, I will give you some conclusions. So let's start with a little bit of background. This graph shows the production of different vegetable oils in the world. The y-axis shows the oil production in millions of metric tons, and the x-axis represents 9 different oilseed crops. The vegetable oil produced the most worldwide is the crude palm oil, followed by the soybean oil and the rapeseed oil. In the fifth position, after the sunflower seed oil, is located the palm kernel oil, which also comes from the oil palm fruit. But why is that? Why crude palm oil is located in the first place? Oil palm is the most efficient oilseed crop in the world. 1 hectare of oil palm may produce up to 10 times more oil than other major oilseed crops such as rapeseed, sunflower, and soybean. To put this in a better perspective, in 2012, only 5.5% of the land dedicated to oilseed crops was used for oil palm, compared with 10% for sunflower, 13% for rapeseed, and 40.1% for soybean. But 39% of the vegetable oil produced in the same year was obtained from oil palm, compared with 8% from sunflower, 16% from rapeseed, and 27% from soybean. This graph shows the palm oil production by country in 2017, and the y-axis represents the oil production in million metric tons. More than 50% of the palm oil in the world is produced by Indonesia, and more than 80% is produced by Indonesia and Malaysia. In the 3rd, 4th, and 5th place is located Thailand, Colombia, and Nigeria, which represent around 7% of the worldwide production. Next question, where is this oil consumed? This graph shows the palm oil consumption by country in 2015, and the y-axis represents the consumption of oil in millions of metric tons. India, Indonesia, the European Union, China, and Malaysia are the 5 countries that consume palm oil the most. So, what is palm oil used for? 71% of palm oil is used for food, cooking, margarine, processed food, chocolate, among others. 24% is dedicated to consumer products such as soap, cosmetics, detergents, candles, feedstock, and so on. And 5% is used as source of energy, electricity, fuel, and heating. And the final question will be the cost of these products. This graph shows the price of palm oil and palm kernel oil from April to October of 2017. Palm kernel oil is more expensive than palm oil. Taking September as an example, the metric ton of palm oil was $724, whereas 1 metric ton of palm kernel oil was $1,346, twice the price of palm oil. Now, let's move into the processing of palm oil extraction. This process starts with the palms. Elais is a genus of palms with 2 species, Elais oleifera and Elais guineensis. The difference between these 2 species is their origin. Elais oleifera, the American oil palm, is native to tropical, Central, and South America. And Elais guineensis, the African oil palm, is native to West and Southwest Africa. This is the principal source of palm oil. In terms of cultivation, it is possible to grow 143 palms per hectare. It takes 2 years for oil palms to produce fruits that are suitable for harvest. But once the palms are producing fruits, they are able to keep producing for up to 30 years, and one oil palm produces around 170 kilograms of fruit per year. This number is important because the fruit is the actual source of oil. There are two desired products from the oil palm: crude palm oil and palm kernel oil. Crude palm oil comes from the mesocarp of the fruit, whereas palm kernel oil comes from the kernel located in the nut of the fruit. This process starts with the harvest of the fruit bunches, their transportation and delivery in the oil palm factory. Once there, bunches are sterilized in an autoclave, then palm fruit is separated from the bunch and the empty bunch is collected to be used as fertilizer or source of energy. After that, free fruits undergo digestion and pressing processes to obtain a mixture of oil, water, and solid impurities, and the pressed cake, nut and fiber. The mixture is then clarified to obtain oil, oily light sludge, and heavy sludge. The oil is dried by vacuum drying, where the oil is pumped to the tank for storage. The oily light sludge goes to a decanter, which produces more oil, water, and the decanter cake, our first byproduct. The heavy sludge is then centrifuged and the effluents are separated from the solid part. The solid portion is then considered the palm oil sludge, our second byproduct. In terms of the pressed cake, nut and fiber are separated and the fiber is used as a source of energy in the factory. The nut is cracked to reduce the particle size and the shells are removed by flaking. Shells are also used as source of energy in the factory. Then, kernel is finally obtained, which undergoes steam conditioning before it's stored. Now let's talk about the kernel processing. Palm kernel oil is obtained by three different ways. The first way is by mechanical extraction. Kernel is pressed once or more times to obtain oil and palm kernel expeller, our third byproduct. The oil is filtrated and packed. This process is simple and cheap, but only 92% of the oil in the fruit is obtained. The second way is by solvent extraction. Kernel is cracked to reduce the particle size and to allow the solvent to act. Then it undergoes solvent extraction, mainly with hexane, to obtain oil and palm kernel meal, our fourth byproduct. The oil goes to a distillation process before it's filtrated and packed. This process is more expensive than the mechanical extraction, but 98% of the oil in the fruit is obtained. The third way is a combination between the mechanical and solvent extraction. Kernel is pressed to obtain oil and palm kernel expeller. Oil is filtrated and packed, but palm kernel expeller undergoes solvent extraction to produce oil and palm kernel meal. The oil goes to a distillation process before it's filtrated and packed. This process is still expensive, but 99% of the oil in the fruit is obtained. Now let's review the byproducts from the whole process. From cultivation to oil extraction, there are 7 byproducts that can be used in animal nutrition: oil palm fronds, oil palm trunks, palm pressed fiber, decanter cake, palm oil sludge, palm kernel expeller, and palm kernel meal. However, not all of them can be used in swine nutrition, and let's see why. Oil palm fronds, oil palm trunks, and palm pressed fiber have a low concentration of crude protein, fat, and ash, and have a high concentration of fiber. Therefore, it is not possible to use for swine nutrition, but they are used for ruminant nutrition. Now let's talk about the swine nutrition interest byproducts. It is possible to use 4 byproducts for palm oil process: palm oil sludge and decanter cake from the fruit processing, and palm kernel expeller and palm kernel meal from the kernel process. Looking at the nutrient composition in dry matter bases of these byproducts, palm oil sludge has a low concentration of dry matter compared with the other three byproducts. The concentration of crude protein in palm oil sludge is higher, but it is due to the low concentration of dry matter. In general, these four byproducts have a concentration of protein that is good enough for swine diets. In terms of the concentration of fat, we can see the difference between palm kernel expeller and palm kernel meal due to the different oil extraction process. The concentration of ash is also good enough for pigs. However, there are limited data about palm oil sludge composition. So let's talk about the other three byproducts. In terms of the concentration of fiber, all of them have a concentration that is high and could be a limitation for pigs. Palm oil sludge and decanter cake has been evaluated and used in ruminant diets, but no data in pigs is available. Therefore, palm kernel expeller and palm kernel meal are the most important byproducts in swine nutrition, and I will talk about the nutritional value of these byproducts in my next podcast. So let's conclude. The oil palm is the most efficient vegetable oil seed crop in the world. There are different palm oil byproducts that can be used in animal nutrition, and some byproducts can be used in swine feeding, but more research is needed in all of them. With this, I would like to thank you all for your attention and all my labmates for their support. And if you want to have more information about this topic, visit our website nutrition.ansai.illinois.edu.